So you figured out that diet culture is toxic and you want nothing to do with it. But you're wondering what you can do to maintain your health in the absence of dieting. How do we pursue healthy habits without restriction? It can be done, and I have four simple tips for you. Tip one, body-led mindful eating. Put away the distractions, sit down, savor every bite. Pay attention to your body's hunger and fullness cues and prioritize pleasure. It may sound simple or overly simplified. And if you have a long history of dieting, it might be a little more challenging than you would think to sense your hunger and fullness cues. But don't worry, we will take a deeper dive on that one in another video. Tip number two, balance and portion control, not restriction. The goal is not to eat like a bird. The goal is not to stop eating before you are full or satisfied. The goal is to make sure there's a variety of food on your plate. Some people find it helpful to start out with smaller portions and then check in with themselves before they go back for more. So when I say portion, I don't mean measure and weigh your food and restrict what you're eating. I mean, select a portion of food, have a variety on your plate, pace yourself, keep checking in while you're eating, and give yourself the freedom to go back for as many seconds as you would like. This is just another tool to encourage you to check in during the eating process. So if you decide that you would like to have some chips, put aside a portion of chips in a bowl, pace yourself, savor what you're eating, and know that you can go back for as much as you want, rather than taking the entire bag of chips with you to lay in bed and chill out. Tip number three, stay active. The secret to finding the perfect form of exercise for you and your body is finding the form of exercise that you will actually do. And what is generally the secret to finding that one? Find what you enjoy. Joyful movement will make exercise fun and rewarding in real time. Instead of delaying your gratification, focus on immediate gratification when it comes to exercise. Strength training is so beneficial, and there are a lot of us who are not wild about that. But even with that, we have to find ways to make our strength training more fun or engaging, whether that means doing it in a social setting, adding music, or thinking of weightlifting in terms of how it affirms your gender. There is generally a way to make it more pleasurable. But outside of that, when you're looking for a form of activity that's right for you, really focus on the fun. For me, I love being outside. I love hiking. I love coming across little critters in the wild. So going for a walk doesn't require any motivation. I will go rain or shine, hot or cold. It's just such a pleasurable experience for me. It doesn't require motivation. So when life goes off the rails, my wellness routine, my joyful movement routine doesn't get interrupted because it is intrinsically rewarding. That is what you are looking for. And if you have trouble thinking of what forms of movement can possibly be fun, no problem. We will explore that as well in a future video. And our final tip, sleep is your secret weapon. Sleep frequently gets overlooked when we think about wellness, but this is a time for your body to rest and repair. Lack of sleep makes it really difficult for your body to function optimally. Aim to get 7 to 9 hours of sleep a night. Play around with that. See what is right for you. That is a general range. Everyone's body is different. Some people do really well on less sleep. Some people do really well on more. Keep checking in with yourself and figure out where your sweet spot is and be open to the fact that that may change as you move through the life cycle. So there you have it, four basic areas to be aware of as you try to maintain your health in the absence of dieting.